Brittany here, and I'm going to teach you how to paint a prayer. So the one that I am teaching today is one of my favorites. So basically, what happened was I was going on a business trip. I was actually coming home, and I was reading a magazine, and there was an interview from Gabby Bernstein, and she had two quotes. She had her "Relax, this is going to be great." And then she also had, "What would you have me do?" And this was a prayer. And I kept trying to memorize the prayer, but I couldn't memorize it. So I was like, oh my gosh, I just need to paint this. And it was, "What would you have me do? Where would you have me go? What would you have me say? And to whom?" And I just absolutely love this. So I'm going to teach you a simple technique that anybody can do. Very simple technique that anybody can do, and then I'm going to, if you have any questions, I'll answer those at the end, but I'm going to teach you how to do that. So basically, you just need some, we've been doing some fun projects, so I have a lot of stuff over there, so I can't throw this over there, but just canvas or wood, and then grab you some stencils of any kind. You can also use bubble wrap, anything like that, and then if you have, whatever kind of paintbrushes you want to use. And then if you have a vinyl cutter, you can use a vinyl cutter for the words, or you can freehand it, okay? I'm going to do start to finish. So feel free to hang out with me, and feel free to just paint with me if you want. If you want to grab some paints, or maybe even just write it down. Feel free to just write it down on a notebook or a piece of paper. Okay, so I'm just going to take some colors, and because I'm doing this with y'all, I'm gonna put the paint on kind of thin because I want to be able to do all the stenciling while I have you here. So the first one I used was bluegrass green, and these are Deco Art Americana. I am really loving these. And then I'm just gonna kind of layer them. I'm gonna pick some colors and just kind of layer them. I know I want to do, you also want to pick out your colors you want to do for your stencil. So here's an example of a background that's ready. So the stenciling, I'm going to show you how to do all of that, and it's really easy to do. All right, so I'm going to put another strip here. Ah! Well, there it goes. It's okay. And that was peacock teal. I'm going to use another strip. And then all I do, guys, again, this is so easy and fun. Anybody can do this. And I just basically, I'm kind of addicted to the blues and greens and turquoises. I think it's just missing the beach and loving the ocean. I just love swimming in warm water. And so I'm just kind of going around the sides. And again, if you don't have a canvas, you can totally do this on wood. You can also just take a pen and some markers, some watercolor. I mean, you could do this just, you know, kind of writing it out. So what I like to tell people is to think of something that means something to them. So both of these behind me mean something to me, okay? And I know, as you know, a busy mom, I've talked about this before, a busy mom, a busy wife, I feel like sometimes we're pushed and pulled in a thousand different directions. I know y'all don't feel that way, but I'm just kidding. I think, you know, just being a woman in general, we feel pushed and pulled in a thousand different directions. And sometimes it's just hard. You know, there's a lot coming at us. And we can sometimes forget just to take time for ourselves. And the other day, you know, I was talking to my doctor, and I was like, you know, TV doesn't always relax me. I think being a creative person, you know, I like TV, but it just doesn't relax me. It's like my brain is like into all the characters and all of that stuff. And then before you know it, I'm more stressed than when I started. And he said, not everybody relaxes by sitting in front of a TV. Like, that's not everybody's way of relaxing. And it just really hit me, because I think I always thought, like, if I wasn't going to do anything, if I need to relax and de-stress, I need to be sitting in front of a TV or, you know, whatever the case may be. And so whenever he said that, I was like, yeah, that's so true. Like, relaxing for me is this. Like, this is when I relax the most. So, yeah, I don't know about y'all, but y'all could tell me or, you know, post in the comments. That would be awesome. But yeah, I'm just kind of doing some blues and greens. And again, it's just simple, nothing major. I put this down like this. And then all I'm doing, guys, is I'm just using a different brush. These I get from the dollar store or Lowe's. Real cheap, easy brushes. And then what I like to do is I like to use these. Now you can use a little makeup sponge. That works too if you want it more precise. But I honestly like it really, I like it kind of messy, and I like to not really worry. So I'm gonna use a Elegant Finish metallic paint. My hands are so messy. Elegant Finish, I'm just gonna kind of pour some of this on a paper plate, and then I'm going to use some of those lighter colors we talked about earlier. So this one is a Sea Breeze. I'm gonna use a Sea Breeze color. This one is really important for me. It's sometimes when I pray, I feel like, you know, yes, you know, we're talking about thankfulness and stuff like that and asking for things to happen. And then sometimes we gotta just remember, like, you know, this prayer that Gabby Bernstein does, you know, it's what would you have me do? Where would you have me go? What would you have me say and to whom? And I think sometimes we just kind of get, you know, overwhelmed with, you know, trying to do it all, trying to do it all and be all to everybody. And if you're a mom or a wife or just a woman in general, you understand what I'm talking about. We put such high expectations on ourselves, and I think sometimes we think we have to be everywhere and anywhere, or it's going to totally ruin that other person's life. I know just, you know, graduations. I mean, we had so many family members graduating from both sides of the family, and it was just overwhelming between, you know, paint parties and graduations, and I was just like, oh my gosh, I can't do this. I can't do all of these and still try to, you know, keep up with everything. So it just got to be where it was so overwhelming. And you know, sometimes in life, I think you just have to, like, think about your health and notice, you know, what you're doing. Just because you can try to please everybody and then you end up, you know, pleasing nobody. And that's not where you want to be. You know, especially health-wise, I'm starting to be a lot more protective of my time. I think maybe with age comes more, I don't know, stupidity or wisdom. I'm not sure which one. Yeah, I'll let you know in about 10 years. Okay, so I'm just kind of adding some colors. Again, I'm not sure how this is going to turn out. We'll see together. We'll see how this turns out in a minute together, and hopefully it will be okay. But again, putting this on here while it's wet, two reasons I do this. The first one, again, it just helps dry everything a little faster. The stencil is probably picking up some of the, yeah, it's picking up some of this paint. Also, if you're teaching this at a paint party, which, by the way, people love, it is so fun. It's like, if you're, you know, like I said earlier, I teach paint parties. And so if you're teaching this at a paint party, the last one I did with the painted prayers, it was like, you know, these women turned into little kids, just painting with stencils and having fun. You know, it's more about the process. And then you also end up with something pretty cool that you can hang on your wall. So if any of y'all do this, I would love, love, love to see your finished product. And again, this is something, if you don't have the supplies for it, just, you know, use Sharpie, do some wood art. One of my friends, Casey Hope, she has a Whatever Letter Facebook group, and is so cool. She does this really awesome hand lettering, and I kind of watch her and I'll do it. And then she actually recommended this 100-day Bible journaling. Actually, I'll grab it and show you. And it's really cool because in her Whatever Letter group, you can, like, write, you know, you can do your Bible study, and then you can write in here like a Bible journal. And so I think that's pretty cool because, you know, it is proven, like, in church, if you're listening and you're taking notes, but you're also drawing, it has been proven scientifically that creative brains, when they draw, they actually retain more than just, you know, just listening. So that's always my excuse when I'm drawing on Pixie's hand or wherever. I always draw on her hand during church or something like that. Then she gets new artwork for her for the day, and then I get to draw and listen. So it's a win-win, people. Win-win. All right, I'm going to use this really pretty color I put down. It's called Country Blue. It just looks really cool. I don't know if y'all can see that. I'm going to try this in the middle a little bit. And then I also have this metallic festive green. I'm going to put a little bit of that on there too. So let me add this in. Because again, stenciling, you can just kind of go crazy. And then when you pick it up, you have all these colors. So you can see how it looks right now. We're about to see what it looks like in a second, the big reveal. So y'all can let me know what you think. Okay, so this is a festive green. And I'm just going to, I haven't rinsed the brush once. I haven't rinsed this at all. So I'm just kind of going in. Let's see. Hopefully it turns out good and I won't disappoint. Can you see? Yeah, it has all those colors. Okay, so now that we have, oh, I like that. I even kind of like how it looks like it has a border from my stencil from the top and bottom. Can y'all see that from there? So here's the thing about these. They're so super easy, and you can do any type that you want. This one, I put more stencils on it afterwards. I did more stuff. I did more coppers. I usually try to do coppers in all of my stuff just because I'm kind of obsessed with copper paint. Let me find a place for this. Hold on. We did geodes earlier today, me and Pixie, and so the whole left side of my table over there is covered with geodes that are drying. I'm gonna take these and cut them out, all right? So these, you know, whenever you do vinyl stenciling, I'm gonna set this here for just a second. Okay, let me point y'all back. All right, so when you do vinyl stenciling, I use a US cutter, which I love, by the way. And I've used a couple of different cutters and did not have the same experience with all of them. So this one I really, really appreciate. And the reason I like it so much is because I can cut out, like let's say I'm doing a party with a ton of people, I can cut out tons of stuff all at once. So let's say I'm, you know, doing a unicorn silhouette or whatever the case may be. I can actually cut out, let's say, 25 unicorn silhouettes at once and have them all done at once. So I don't have to sit there at my machine and hit, like, cut now, cut now. I can cut them all. So this one, once I have it how I wanted it, and I designed the words where I wanted them, I designed the lettering, all of that good stuff. But the stencils I actually design, I pick the lettering. There's tons of fonts that I choose, and I pick the lettering. And then I just cut them out closer. And the trick is with stenciling, when you're using it for canvas or wood or whatever the case may be, you want to have it dry before you put the stencils on, and then you want to pull them off when it's wet, okay? It is very important that you put it on there, you stencil, you pull off immediately. Because some people are thinking they're supposed to leave them the whole time to dry. And when you do that, it pulls off all the paint, all right? So make sure you don't do that because it will pull off all the paint. So I'm just cutting out kind of close to these so that I have more control. And so it doesn't, if it is sticking, because I'm kind of doing this while it's wet, we'll see how it works out, because I want to be able to do this while y'all can see it. And you can freehand this. Like I said, I used to freehand all of my words. I used to never do vinyl stenciling. And then I started realizing that people at my paint parties really liked to have the stenciling. So I decided to start doing some of them. And then after it just became really, really popular, then I decided to get the vinyl cutter. All right, so I'm gonna take this and start putting on the stencils. Okay, so let me point y'all down. All right, so make sure I put the words in the right thing. What would you make sure I got the right one? Okay, what would you? So on this one, I did them smaller, the top word, and then bigger. I actually changed it this time. So what would you? Because I think sometimes in our prayers, we need to remember, you know, like there's definitely somebody in control here, and we can pray for thankfulness, of course, and pray for specific things, but then sometimes, too, we need to let God handle it. Okay, so I just put it down. I peeled off the back, and I'll show you all a little closer on the next one. I use my fingernails to just kind of lightly put it on there, and then, and I hope y'all can see this. Let me know if you can. And this is where you want to peel off the top part. So I'm holding both sides and then pulling all the way to the right. And because it's pretty wet, I'm getting a lot of paint pulled off. So it might not work out as great as I'm hoping. So to recap what I just said, so it doesn't confuse y'all, and you want your background to be dry before you start doing it, but then once you paint it, then you want to immediately take it off. Okay, I'm gonna do pure white. I'm just gonna put it on this little piece of cardboard I have over here, and then I'm just going to dab it. And we might have a little problem, so if so, it's because I'm not waiting long enough for it to dry. But also, I don't want to get the blow dryer out. I don't want to do that. I'm just going to switch to a smaller brush and make sure I get all the little areas. And hopefully it won't pull up too much of the paint. So then again, if it does, just know that we have to wait a little bit longer for it to dry. But doing this live and showing y'all, I want y'all to be able to see it. Okay, so I have it painted, and then I'm just pulling it up, and then I'm just gonna throw this away. Okay. Oh, not too bad. Okay, so what would you, and then we have a little dental tool. You can get these at Harbor Freight, and I take the little insides of it off, but I don't do that until it has dried a little bit. That part you can wait until it dries. So what would you have me do? I'm gonna put that right there, and I can see this is really wet, my little triangles. Oh well, we'll see what happens. The thing about art, you just gotta have fun with it. Don't do so much stressing. Maybe that's why I love painting so much, because I just like, just go for it. It doesn't really hurt my feelings if it doesn't turn out exactly perfect, because I know I've had fun doing it. So what would you have me do is the first one. Just a little fingernail action here, and then I'm just gonna pull this off. And this is a little tricky. If you don't have fingernails, borrow a neighbor, borrow a friend. So it takes just a minute to get this part separate. So I peeled off the back. It's like kind of like putting a sticker on a car. And again, this is just so you can use that inside to get your stencil. Yeah, it's pulling a lot of paint. See all the paint it's pulling off? That's all right then. All right, I'm going to take a little bit more white, get the bulk down, and then I'm going to switch to my smaller brush. And you want to make sure you have a good contrast. So whatever layer you put on the bottom, if you're doing white words, just make sure that it's dark enough that it's going to show up. If you're doing the letters in black, like I have over here, and just make sure the background is light enough so that it has a really good contrast. All right, so I'm just pulling this off. Oh, good. It's not pulling off too bad. I got this right. I just released something earlier, a Paint Party business guide. Actually, you're going to see it in I Misspelled Business. I was like, great. This is wonderful. So I had to go back and change some stuff. Like, lovely. I do that sometimes. Okay, there is so much paint on my hands, it's like I can't tell what is pulling and what's not because of this greatness. Yeah, I would love to know if you've ever done a paint party before. Those of you out there that may be interested, or maybe you've done one, a lot of times people think, you know, especially if they do like fine art, they kind of have like a negative look towards it. But here's the thing, when I first started teaching paint parties, I seriously thought, I gotta push back that little thing. I seriously thought it was just gonna be extra money for my family and it would be fun. That's really all I thought about it. I had no idea that it was really gonna help people. You know, it's totally changed my family's life, but then also it helps people because, you know, I always talk about art heals, always. And sometimes you'll have like kind of like fine artists that, you know, I think some people sometimes, you know, put their nose up at paint parties and that's dumb and it's not real art. Well, here's the thing. What I have learned throughout this many years of teaching paint parties is that so many people that maybe a fine artist would have never been able to talk to or reach, you can show a beginner person who maybe has never painted, or maybe they painted when they were younger and time got away from them and they started painting. You can teach that to somebody and then it's kind of like the gateway, you know, like Jenny, my friend, she says, paint parties are the gateway drug to a creative life. And the reason I just love that quote from her is because, it's so true. You know, I'll get messages from people that, you know, are like, oh my gosh, I went and I bought paints and we painted at my family's, you know, reunion, or I'm painting now all the time and it's really helped me through a hard time. And so I think sometimes people can, you know, oh, it's not fine art, it's not real art. Well, there's a place for everything. There's a place for fine art. There's a place for, you know, doing geodes with glitter and just having a fun time with my daughter this morning. There's, and by the way, they're still drying. I think it's going to be a few days. You know, there's time for, you know, me taking a prayer or a quote that I just want to memorize so bad, because in that moment when I am about to have a meltdown, I can look and realize, like, relax. It's, you know, it turns out great. A quote like that that means something so much to me. There is a place for all of it. And so, you know, just if those of you out there, if you've been thinking about hosting a paint party or teaching paint parties, or maybe you're crafty and you just need to start making some extra money, you know, and your husband's, you know, working all the time and in still aren't meeting, you know, whatever the case may be, where would you have me go? You know, if you need it for that, like I know when I was doing paint parties, I was, you know, teaching full time and I started doing these on the side and just started making extra money, and then they just kept picking up and I kept booking, and then I was like, oh my gosh, I can't do both of these, I need to pick one. And so it just got to a point where, again, I pulled off the back, and now I'm pulling off the top, just a little bit with my fingernails. And then it just got to where, you know, I was teaching full time, then I went down to part time, and now I just, you know, do this full time, and I love it. You know, entrepreneurship is definitely not for the weak, that's for sure. You will have lots of ups and downs, but you know, you do in any type of job, you know, it's just normal. But this, I can honestly say, is just, it's just fun. You know, I was teaching some kids the other night at this place, and we were doing a watercolor Zentangle event, and this little girl, she was like 3 years old, she was at my event, and the thing said like 5 to 12, but I guess they really wanted their kids to do it, and I was like, okay, you know, she'll be fine. And she started to kind of walk off, because that's what three-year-olds do. They want to go where they want to go if you have three-year-olds. And I remember, you know, I was kind of like, oh my gosh. So I walked over there and I was like, come be my helper. And she kind of looked up and I said, here, hold my hand. Let's go help the other kids. And so we were walking around, and for about a minute she was okay. And then she was like, this ain't going to work. And so I was like, do you mind if I hold you? And she's like, yes. And so I had like a baby on my hip, and I was just teaching this paint party, and it was so funny. But you know, the whole time it was a blast. You know, the kids are having fun. I was outside, band was playing, people were eating crawfish, and it was just a fun time. And so I always, you know, in those moments, I'm just always grateful. Like, thank you, God, for letting me, you know, get to hang out with new people, see new places, and do new things all the time. I love it. I think being an artist, it's kind of like, I feel like I need that. You know, I need to meet new people and see new places, and we're creative, you know, we're kind of built for that. So it's just really, it's been really fun. And so if you're ever thinking about teaching a paint party, or you just want to do stuff like this, like, make sure you make time for it. What would you have me say? Make sure you make time for it. You know, it's important. A lot of times we go through our day and we think we don't have any time. But when we, you know, add the hours we're on social media, or we add the hours that we're on TV, or whatever the case may be, sometimes there's more time than you think, you know? I know this morning is a perfect example. We had a dentist appointment at 7 a.m. And yes, I scheduled a stupid dentist appointment at 7 in the morning during summer. Pixie's out for summer now. And so we get up at 6:30 this morning, get ready real fast, run to the dentist, and then we're like, all right, well, let's go ahead and take Blue for a walk. So we take Blue for a walk. Then we're like, well, let's make geodes this morning. Let's do some glitter art and metallic paint art, which if you haven't seen that, I posted a tutorial earlier today you can look at. And so then we do that, and then I go do a little bit of work, and then I come in, and Pixie's, you know, making some stuff for her birthday plans, and she's like, what time is it? And I'm like, it's 10 o'clock. And she's like, what? I mean, we had so much done before 10 a.m., which usually we would just be getting up, you know, sleeping all morning, which is really nice. I might do tomorrow. Can I do that? I don't think I can do that, but... yeah, so it's just funny, you know, sometimes we have more time than we think. It's just what we choose to do with it is maybe, you know, we need to put some boundaries in our life, or we need to put some self-discipline. And I am speaking to myself, people. This is not anything towards you. I'm speaking to myself because, you know, sometimes I'll think, well, I don't have time. And then I'll think, well, oh my gosh, I did this or that, or I could have cut this out. And then did something I really wanted to do. So it's all about just making time for it. And I'm just adding these last things. In a second, I'm going to show you how I take off the little pieces, and then it's almost done. So who thinks they can paint a prayer now, or an inspirational quote? Or who has? Who has already done that? I would love to see. Okay, so I just kind of filled that in so far. Again, something so simple, but if you pick a quote or a thing that is personal and meaningful to you, then it's going to be very meaningful. So this might not really mean much to you, but if you had an inspirational quote, and again, I'm just pulling the back off. There's three pieces here. And at first, it's kind of hard to do. It's kind of hard to do, but once you get used to it, I mean, Pixie teaches these. She'll teach people how to do this at my events. well, I should say our events. She seems to be running a lot of them these days. Okay, and I'll just push that down. Yeah, that's another thing. Those of y'all that do have kids, Pixie's been kind of helping with my paint party since she was 5 or 6. And at first, you know, I do have to admit, she would basically put a few brushes down and then she'd run around everywhere. And then she would, you know, run and get the candy I had out or whatever it was. And then every year she got a little better and a little better. And now she can, like, you know, a few years ago I got sick and I lost my voice altogether. And I had like 35 women come into this event. And I thought I was going to get my voice back, and I could not get it back. And I was like, Pixie, do you think you could teach the event tonight? Because that's all I could say. And she was like, what? Are you kidding? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. You know, I mean, I do pay her. It's not just, you know, making her do stuff. She does like to earn money. I'm teaching her the value of a dollar too. And so it was about 30 something women that night, and she taught the entire paint party. I whispered along every once in a while when I could, but she basically taught the whole thing, and it was so awesome. So, I mean, it didn't, you know, obviously the first paint party wasn't like that, but now that she's done them, you know, if I do big events, I'll try to bring her on stage with me so that she can get used to public speaking. You know, because that was a huge fear of mine, public speaking and things like that. And I just like, you know, being able to give her opportunities. So some of y'all that have kids, you might think, oh, I can't do that because I have a young one, or, you know, whatever the case may be. You can start to, like, bring them into smaller parts of it and then start to see them. I know a lot of the women that are in my paint party headquarters or have taken my online boot camp class, they totally, like, will have their kids helping and, you know, do designs and stuff like that. And it's just, I don't know, I think it's pretty cool. We definitely have a kind of a family-operated business happening in our house. And I've found, too, if you do teach paint parties, it's really, I mean, people really are, you know, I don't think inspiring quotes are ever going to go out of style. You know, I say that, and maybe they do, but I just don't think they will. Because people, you know, especially, like, I don't know about y'all, but if I'm walking around and I see something, yeah, I can go buy something from Hobby Lobby or Michaels anytime, but if it's something that I've made and I've put my hands and paint and created, it just has more of a special meaning. It has a bigger meaning behind it. You know, I put my time in this and love into it, and now, you know, I get to see what I created. And I like that these painted prayers can kind of represent, like, the time that I was in. So it's almost like, you know, this is what's going on right now with me, you know, like where my focus is. And then, you know, in a few years, another inspirational quote or another Bible verse might be really important to me at that time, depending on what I'm going through in life. And so, you know, the relax, it's going to be great. You know, I love that quote by her, and I just kept trying to remind myself, like, what exactly did she say? And I would say it wrong, and then I was like, I just need to paint this. I need to paint this so I can walk by it and look at it every once in a while and just remind myself, like, you know, enjoy all of this awesome creativeness. You know, yes, things get busy, but there is so much fun stuff happening. And so if I, you know, if we don't take a minute just to breathe and to enjoy it, you know, it why? You know, why do it if you can't take a minute and enjoy it? So I'm just pulling that off. And now I'm going to take it and I'm going to use the dental tool. I'm going to stand up and do this like this to see if you can see. I might get my hair painted. We'll see. And then I just kind of push in there and pull out like that. If you made a mistake like I just did, there's a couple things you can do. You can use a wet brush to kind of, you know, get that white off of there. Or you can use a baby wipe. Baby wipes are so good for acrylic paint. Because if it's wet, oh, that reminded me of that game from Wheel of Fortune where you, like, throw the little things down and it gets in the money because this popped off. if paint is wet, a baby wipe will take it right off. So it's pretty awesome. I always bring baby wipes to my paint parties. So I'm just pulling this off. And the paint party business guide that you can have access to, if you don't have it already, you can send me your email address and I'll send you the paint party business guide. And basically it tells you how to find your customers and how to contact and communicate with your customers so that you can, if you want to try to start paint parties. Or maybe you've started paint parties but you've hit a wall and you're just really, you know, struggling to move to the next thing. It's a guide and it's also a video of me giving you a bunch of tips and things that I use right now, things that I currently use and things that I do that help me with my business. So if you want access to that, just shoot me a message and there might be a link below. There should be a link. If not, then shoot me a message with your email and I'll send you through email. Okay, so this is where I kind of got it on there. So I cannot find my baby wipes. So I'm just gonna use a paper towel and some random water and make my own baby wipe. Let's see if this works. And then I'm just gonna wipe that off. So right here, I got white paint on there where I didn't want it. And so if I had a baby wipe, did I ruin my shirt? I told you I was probably gonna ruin it before this thing was over. And then where'd my little tool go? There it is. And then I'm just pulling this off. All right, and I just got a couple more. So what would you have me do? Where would you have me go? What would you have me say and to whom? Anyway, I hope y'all enjoyed this. Let me know what you think. And also, if you have somebody that may be interested, if you'll share this with them, and maybe they want to create their own as well, or maybe it's something you and a friend can do together. If you want to let a friend know, y'all can, you know, grab some coffee and then get together and do a painted prayer. That'd be such a fun afternoon. I know a few ladies I'd love to sit down and do this with. It'd be so fun. All right, I hope y'all had a great time, and let me know if you want to see more stuff like this.